Jai Hind students, in this video I am going to give you a view of chloroplast organelle that is responsible for photosynthesis in green plants. While viewing this chloroplast organelle, we came to know that this chloroplast organelle made up of a membranous system and stroma. It has its own DNA also, ribosomes and many other chemicals. This membranous system is made up of piled like structure, sac structure, that singular unit is called as thylakoid, and then when they are sacked upon each other, they are piled upon each other, then they become grana. Several grana are joined by lamellae, tube-like membranous system, membranal structure. This is called as a stroma thylakoid or stroma lamellae. These structure is responsible for the light reaction, which in turn produce ATP, which is responsible for the formation of glucose. It provides all the energy that is responsible for converting the CO2 and H2O into glucose. So formation of glucose is a self-driven system in which all the ATPs required is formed by the membranous system that is found in chloroplast organelle. So in this video I am trying to make you understand the 3D view where the light reaction taking place, how the sunlight is falling upon that membranous system, and the light harvesting complexes means the chemicals, the pigments and proteins and other oxidants chemical like NADPH all form the light harvesting complexes. How the light harvesting complexes is distributed among these membranous system means grana thylakoid, stroma lamellae, this. Okay, now imagine that this is 2D structure of your chloroplast. ये जो स्ट्रक्चर है ये आपको पेपर में ड्रॉ करने का स्ट्रक्चर है, 2D स्ट्रक्चर है, बट द सेल एंड ऑर्गेनल्स आर फाउंड इन 3D स्ट्रक्चर. इमेजिन दैट दिस इज द क्लोरोप्लास्ट. ओके, दिस इज योर क्लोरोप्लास्ट. आई हैव एनी हाउ मैनेज टू मेक दिस स्ट्रक्चर बाय यूजिंग द पेट्री डिश वॉच ग्लासेस. दिस इज योर क्लोरोप्लास्ट एंड वॉट यू आर सीइंग हेयर एंड हेयर इज द ग्रैनम. ओके, this is the granum and this is the stroma lamellae. और भी बहुत सारे इस पूरे भरे रहेंगे, but I have managed only to make two granum and the joining stroma lamellae. Okay, this is your, imagine that this is your chloroplast. You can see while if I am opening this chloroplast like this, then you will see that how these granum are arranged one upon each other by single thylakoid, and this tubular like structure, membranous structure, is stroma lamellae, and this space, this ground space, is the stroma. This membranous system is responsible for the formation of ATP, and here the glucose formation of glucose takes place, means the reactions that is responsible for the formation of glucose takes place. ATP synthesized here is used here for the formation of glucose. Since it is a light driven reaction, this granum and this stroma lamellae has certain chemicals. First of all, it has pigments. That pigments are arranged in a pigment system having a reaction center and antenna molecules. The reaction center that is already given in your book is made up of chlorophyll A, and antenna molecules is made up of accessory pigments of all like chlorophyll B, C, D, carotenoids, phycobilins, etc. So all these chemicals, these in this granum, it is filled. Okay, now agar इस मेम्ब्रेनस सिस्टम को मैं इस पेज पर दिखाने की कोशिश कर रही हूँ, इस मेम्ब्रेनस सिस्टम को दैट इज मेड अप ऑफ ग्रैनम एंड स्ट्रोमा लैमेली. इमेजिन दैट वी आर अरेंजिंग दिस ग्रैनम, हमने क्लोरोप्लास्ट से इसके ग्रैनम और स्ट्रोमा लैमेली को बाहर निकाला एंड इमेजिन दैट दिस इज स्ट्रोमा, ये आपका क्लोरोप्लास्ट का स्ट्रोमा है, ये ऑल स्ट्रोमा आपका क्लोरोप्लास्ट है और ये आपका ग्रैनम है. ओके, इसको इनलार्ज्ड करने के लिए मैंने वॉच ग्लास का यूज किया है एंड दिस ट्यूबुलर स्ट्रक्चर लैमिलर स्ट्रक्चर ज्वाइनिंग द ग्रैनम इज द स्ट्रोमा लैमिली. ओके, नाउ यू कैन सी दैट द सिंगल स्ट्रक्चर दिस इज थाइलेकॉइड. ये जो आपका स्ट्रक्चर है ये थाइलेकॉइड है और ये सैक लाइक स्ट्रक्चर है, मीन्स बोरी. यू अंडरस्टैंड बोरी, बैग इन विच वी कैन पुट समथिंग. सो दिस इज सैक लाइक स्ट्रक्चर, डबल मेम्ब्रेनस एंड इनसाइड इट लाइट हार्वेस्टिंग कॉम्प्लेक्सेज इज लोकेटेड. वॉट डू मीन बाई लाइट हार्वेस्टिंग कॉम्प्लेक्स? मीन्स द पिगमेंट्स, ऑल पिगमेंट्स, एसेसरी पिगमेंट्स एंड क्लोरोफिल ए, द मेजर पिगमेंट दैट इज क्लोरोफिल ए, एसेसरी पिगमेंट्स दैट आर कैरेटिनॉइड्स, जैंथोफिल एंड क्लोरोफिल बी सी डी ई, ऑल द टाइप्स ऑफ क्लोरोफिल एक्सेप्ट, ऑल द पिगमेंट्स एक्सेप्ट क्लोरोफिल ए फॉर्म्स द एंटीना मॉलिक्यूल एंड आर कॉल्ड एसेसरी पिगमेंट्स एंड क्लोरोफिल ए फॉर्म्स द मेजर रिएक्शन सेंटर एंड इट कॉल्ड मेजर पिगमेंट्स along with several proteins that help to carry the electrons and oxidation reaction that give rise to ATP formation. All these chemicals are filled inside it. So it is sac-like structure. The single structure, the single unit is called as thylakoid. Now this thylakoid is arranged like in a piled manner in this way. Okay, like coins are put one upon each other, in the same way these thylakoids are arranged upon each other and like this. When the thylakoid are piled upon each other, they become, this unit become grana. Okay, this single unit become grana. These different grana are joined by membranous structure that is the stroma lamellae. Okay, so this is the membranous system and all these ground cytoplasm is called stroma, where there will be DNA, ribosomes, lipids, all the substances, many proteins or enzymes, and in here the glucose cycle is taking place, means glucose formation is taking place, dark reaction, and in this the light reaction is taking place. Now you know that light harvesting complexes LHC that is made up of different pigments and proteins and responsible for the light reaction formation of ATP is of two types depending upon the wavelength absorbed by this antenna molecule by this reaction center chlorophyll A. Means the light harvesting complexes depending upon the wavelength absorbed by this reaction center chlorophyll A is of two type. Okay, the first discovered type was named as PS1 and here in this the reaction molecule will absorb the wavelength of light having 700 nm. Means it will absorb the sunlight of wavelength 700 nm and it will be called as PS1. Now PS2, here the chlorophyll A will absorb the wavelength that is 680 nm. So here you have to, children, apply some physics. You all know, if you will study wave in physics, you will know that wave is inversely proportional to frequency. वेवलेंथ जो होता है वो इन्वर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू फ्रीक्वेंसी है. दैट इज वेवलेंथ इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय लैम्डा. वन मिनट. वेवलेंथ इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय लैम्डा. लैम्डा इज इक्वल टू एच म्यू. मीन्स हेयर वेवलेंथ इज इन्वर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड फ्रीक्वेंसी इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू एनर्जी. Okay, this frequency is directly proportional to energy. It means wavelength is also inversely proportional to energy, you can say, because frequency is directly proportional to energy. So wavelength is inversely proportional to energy also. It means that if the wavelength is large, energy is less. If the wavelength is large, it will be large, then energy will be less. Means agar wavelength jo hai wo large hoga to energy iski kam hogi. Same system you have to apply in LHC, PS2 and PS1. Then you can understand where PS2 will be present and where PS1 will be present. PS2 and PS1 system, we know that here PS1 can absorb the wavelength of 700 nm and PS2 will absorb the wavelength of 680 nm. It means the wavelength here is smaller, so the energy is larger. And from where we are getting the energy, that is sunlight. It means here energy means the intensity of sunlight. Means this photosystem can absorb the wavelength when the sunlight is highly intensified, highly bright. Okay, energy of the sunlight will be large. Then when the energy of the sunlight will be large, when the sunlight is very intensified, tej dhoop hogi, kadak dhoop hogi, tab ye PS2 system aapka sunlight ko absorb karega. It means iska location aap pata kar sakte hain ki ye grana aur stroma lamelli mein kahan hoga. Main isko batati hu. PS1 जो सिस्टम है वो 700 nm को एब्जॉर्ब करता है, लार्जर वेवलेंथ है, इट मींस ये स्मॉलर एनर्जी इसमें रहेगा. सनलाइट जो है वो स्मॉलर एनर्जी के दौरान ये वेवलेंथ, इस वेवलेंथ को प्रोड्यूस करेगा और ये सिस्टम लार्जर वेवलेंथ स्मॉलर एनर्जी के दौरान एक्टिव होगा. एंड हेयर एनर्जी इज टोटली रिलेटेड टू द सनलाइट, लाइट एनर्जी दैट इज फॉलिंग ऑन द ग्रीन लीव्स. ओके, सो while seeing this system of granum, like this grana are arranged in the chloroplast. Grana is tarah arranged hai chloroplast mein aur inko sunlight absorb karna hai. So if I am making to fall sunlight on them, then you just by seeing this arrangement, you can say that where the PS2 will takes place and where the PS1 is and where there is PS1. So imagine the sunlight is falling on the leaf. Okay, these all are taking the sunlight. This sun, the part, all the parts that is directly exposed to sunlight, that is directly exposed to sunlight, means the boundary of the granum, this boundary of the granum, this stroma lamellae, this boundary of the granum and stroma lamellae are getting highly intensified sunlight. So here PS1 will be situated. Yahan pe jo ATP formation mein जो सिस्टम लाइट हार्वेस्टिंग कॉम्प्लेक्स रोल प्ले करेगा वो PS1 रहेगा, क्योंकि आप देखो जैसे ही लाइट इस पे फॉल हो रहा है, सो डायरेक्ट लाइट इस एजेस पे पड़ रहे हैं, इनके एजेस पे, ग्रैनम के एजेस पर एंड स्ट्रोमा लैमेली पर. ओके, सो द दीज एजेस आर कॉल्ड एज एप्रेस्ड पार्ट, दीज एजेस आर कॉल्ड एज नॉन एप्रेस्ड पार्ट विच आर इन द डायरेक्ट touch of sunlight. These are called as non-appressed part of the membranous system. Means that are direct contact in the sunlight. These edges of the grana, stroma lamellae, and all the parts that is in direct contact of sunlight. Sunlight is falling direct here. So the sunlight energy gained here will be high and PS1 will be active. Okay. Now these parts are called as non-appressed part. What about the parts? Means this is whole 3D structure, sack-like structure. Or agar is pe rakha hua hai, what you will say about this part? Yahan pe bhi chemicals sare bhare hue hain. To yahan pe kaun sa sunlight ka wavelength pahunch pa raha hai? Aap dekh sakte hain, ye jo part hai, membranous ka ye part, थैलेक्वाइड का ये पार्ट, वो एक दूसरे पे अरेंज्ड है और डायरेक्ट सनलाइट से छुप गया है. इट इज हाइडिंग अवे फ्रॉम डायरेक्ट सनलाइट. जो डायरेक्ट सनलाइट इस एजेस पे पड़ रहे हैं वो इसके इस मेम्ब्रेनस के इस पार्ट पे डायरेक्ट नहीं हो रहा है. सो हेयर लेस इंटेंसिफाइड एनर्जी ऑफ द सनलाइट विल रीच एंड हेयर PS1 विल बी एक्टिव. PS2 विल ऑल्सो बी प्रेजेंट बट हेयर PS1 विल बी एक्टिव हैविंग द वेवलेंथ दैट इज लार्जर. ओके एंड इन द बाउंड्री पार्ट इन द एजेस पार्ट नॉन एप्रेस्ड पार्ट PS सिस्टम 2 इज प्रेजेंट. PS सिस्टम 2 इज एबसेंट इन द एप्रेस्ड पार्ट. द पार्ट दैट इज हाइडिंग दैट इज फार अवे फ्रॉम द डायरेक्ट सनलाइट इज द एप्रेस्ड पार्ट. मीन्स दिस इज द एप्रेस्ड पार्ट. इन एप्रेस्ड पार्ट ओनली PS1 इज प्रेजेंट बिकॉज द सनलाइट इज नॉट फॉलिंग डायरेक्टली. हेयर द एनर्जी इज लेस सो द वेवलेंथ ऑफ द सनलाइट इज लार्ज एंड PS सिस्टम 1 विल बी एक्टिव. इन द मेम्ब्रेनस सिस्टम हेयर द लाइट इज डायरेक्ट द एनर्जी इज इंटेंसिफाइड एंड वेवलेंथ ऑफ लार्ज वेवलेंथ ऑफ स्मॉल मीन्स 680 दैट इज PS1 इज एक्टिव. सो आप जब हायर क्लास में या किसी टेक्स्ट बुक में अप्रेस्ड एंड नॉन अप्रेस्ड पार्ट ऑफ थैलेकॉइड पढ़ेंगे सो दिस इज द मीनिंग ऑफ अप्रेस्ड एंड नॉन अप्रेस्ड पार्ट. ऑल द एजेस एंड द मेम्ब्रेनस सिस्टम द पार्ट दैट इज फार अवे फ्रॉम द दैट इज हाइडिंग अवे फ्रॉम द सनलाइट इज द अप्रेस्ड पार्ट एंड दिस स्ट्रोमा लैमेली द एजेस आर द नॉन अप्रेस्ड पार्ट. ओके सो आई हैव ट्राइड माई बेस्ट टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ दीज membranous system is responsible for and how this membranous system PS1 and PS2 is distributed in this membranous system. Now these all thylakoids are filled of LHC. Sunlight is falling, the electrons will excite and they will be transferred one from another chemicals having lower energy. And the energy that is released is utilized for phosphorylation and formation of ATP. After that formation, you will read the formation of glucose. So, by understanding this, many students are asking about the arrangement of this grana and they are not able to understand how this grana is arranged and how the light is falling and where the PS1 and PS2 will be situated. So you can easily correlate the distribution of PS1 and PS2. The PS1 having high wavelength 700 will be situated in the appressed part, in the hiding part of the thylakoid, and PS2 that is having the wavelength of 680, so the sunlight energy will be intensified, and where it will be find the portion that is directly in facing the sunlight. So it is all about your I have provided you the notes also making the non-appraised part. Like if you will compare this non-appraised part, this is the non-appraised part, stroma lamellae, and the edges I have made like this, that is the that is also non-appraised part, and the surface that is touching one another, the thylakoid that is piled upon one another, and this surface is the appraised part and having PS1. Okay, so this you can imagine the structure of membranous system that is made up of grana thylakoid, stroma lamellae, and responsible for the ATP formation for with the help of sunlight. I have tried my best. Please read the book also, and you can see the others video also to understand this concept far better. Thank you.